Merce Cunningham. He was a dancer and a choreographer, and I think he was probably one of the most visionary and influential choreographers the world has known. In the film, he also says, you know, any movement is good for dancing, right? I mean, he was not an elitist. You know, he was part of the American avant-garde, but he was really interested in movement, you know, and that's why he says, I'm a dancer first. This idea of communicating through the physical action is really something that was very important to him. And he just was devoted to that and dedicated. I think that dance is an underdog of all the art forms, just by the nature of it. Because, you know, you have to be there to see the performance, and when you're there, you see the performance and then it's gone. And that's why just people don't know him as well as they know Rauschenberg or Warhol or all these artists he worked with, you know, Jasper Johns, and there's just so many. But because you can just go in the museum and you can see picture or painting over and over again, you can listen to a piece of music, there's a recording. But dance, I mean, nobody watches dance videos or rehearsal videos. So I think by the nature of the art form, dance is an underdog. So that was it with this film, and it's probably a quest of my whole life to try a way to communicate, to bring this art form to people.
We don't interpret something, we present something, we do something, and then any kind of interpretation is left up to anybody looking at it in the audience.
Since we picked a period between 42 and 72, Merce was incredibly prolific. So within that 30 years, he made 80 dances. So some of them survived, some of them basically disappeared. So we went through most of them. But there were some iconic ones, you know. Most of them have to do with collaboration with Rauschenberg, because that's the era of they made like 16 collaborations at that time out of 22. So we basically picked iconic works, and then from those iconic works, we picked excerpts. And then we were trying to translate his ideas, not his dances, but his ideas into cinema. And if again you start thinking about that, how would cinema deal with falling? How would cinema deal with closeness or togetherness? How would cinema deal with layering and so on? Some of those pieces, like one piece is based on Dostoevsky, you know, so it's, what's that like and why is it? So we just went deeply in each dance, and then we tried to find locations that would help translate his ideas into cinema. I mean, to me, the most cinematic of all that really worked, it's a Winter Branch. It's the one on the rooftop, because something happened there. It turned into real cinema. You know, it just even went away from the dance. And I really tried to get this away from the dance world, from the stage, you know, that it's not about being on stage, it's about something else. And I think that dance really crossed over. I've been making dance films for maybe over 15 years, and there's a difference between capturing dance and engaging with cinema, right? So what I've been trying to sort of do is, we're thinking about Merce in this film in cinema terms. There's a people who engage with cinema, and I think that's the way basically to bring dance to the audience. It's never gonna be the same as on stage, and nobody pretends to be. It's not in opposition. You know, it's about finding another art form. And I think that's actually exciting, because cinema has proven it over and over again.